Now that we have Twilio and Airtable accounts ready to roll, we can start building our SMS application using Twilio Studio. Twilio Studio is a visual programming tool that lets anyone build voice and SMS applications without writing any code. We'll get things started by configuring a Twilio phone number to respond with different messages based on the content of the message that's sent to the number. Get stoked, people. It's time to send some text messages. Let's get started. Head on out to the Twilio console and navigate to the Twilio Studio homepage. Once again, you may need to expand the left nav menu to find the Twilio Studio link. Do future you a favor and pin this icon to your left nav so you can find it easily later. Next, create a new Studio flow. You can name it anything you like. When you create a flow, you can start with a template that has some functionality built in, but this time we're going to start from scratch. A flow is a set of instructions that tells Twilio what to do when one of your phone numbers receives a call or text. You set up those instructions by dragging and dropping widgets onto a flow's workspace and connecting them together, kind of like Legos. Your application flow starts with a trigger, an event that kicks everything off. In our case, that's going to be an incoming SMS message. So at this point, we want our application to respond with one of two messages based on what the user texts into our phone number. To make that happen, we'll drag in a send message widget and set up our first message. This one will be our default message, the one that we send back if the user doesn't text in one of our magic words. The default message will contain a list of all the keywords users can text into our phone number and what those keywords do. For now, the only keyword we're going to handle is map. When someone texts in that word, we're going to respond with a different message that contains more information about our march. Let's drag in another send message widget that'll handle the map keyword. In this case, we're going to send back a different message with information about the march. We're also going to include an image which has a map of the area and markup indicating where we want to meet up. The send message widget can be configured with a media URL. This is just a URL somewhere on the internet for the image file we'd like to send with our message. If you need a place to stash a media file like this one, you can use Twilio Assets, which lives in the runtime section of the console. Click the big red button to add an asset, and navigate to the folder on your computer which contains the image you'd like to send. In a few seconds, it should be uploaded and ready to use in your application. Copy the image URL to your clipboard and return to your Studio flow. Paste in the image URL in the text box and click Save. Okay, so now we have two messages ready to be sent out, but we haven't set up any conditional logic yet to determine which message should be sent out and when. The tool we have to do this in Twilio Studio is the split based on widget, which will examine the incoming message and determine which path to follow. Let's drag that widget into the flow right now and connect it with the incoming message trigger. After we do that, we need to configure this widget to test some piece of data in our flow. In this case, we want to test the text of the incoming message to determine if it contains one of our keywords. In the dropdown, you'll see a number of different variables you can inspect at this step in the flow. The one we want is the body of the message which triggered our flow in the first place. Now we need to set up our flow to branch off in different directions based on what the user sent in. The first piece we'll set up is the default path, the one we'll choose if the user doesn't send back a keyword that our application understands. After that, we'll create a condition on our split widget that says that anytime a user sends in a text message that contains the word map, we want to branch off in this direction of the flow. Select the contains test from the dropdown and type in the word map in the text box below it. This condition will be matched regardless of whether the end user types upper or lowercase characters. With that, our flow is all set to start responding to incoming messages. Click the Publish button to ensure all of your latest changes have been saved. Now that your flow is published, copy the webhook URL for the flow and head over to the programmable SMS section of the console. Remember that messaging service we created previously? Now we're going to configure our messaging service to use our brand new Studio flow to respond to any incoming SMS messages sent to the numbers in that phone number pool. tick the Process Incoming Messages checkbox and paste in the webhook URL for your studio flow. When you click Save, all the phone numbers in your pool begin processing incoming messages using the Twilio Studio flow you just created. Now it's time to reap the rewards of your labor in Twilio Studio and test your application. Send an SMS to one of the phone numbers in your number pool. If the message didn't contain the word map, you should receive the default message. Text in the word map, and in a few moments you should receive an MMS message containing the image that we uploaded. Please note, however, that MMS messaging currently only works in the US and Canada. Great work, my friend. You have successfully created an SMS keyword application in Twilio Studio. But your journey is far from over. Complete the challenge described below to receive your reward and move on to your next objective. Good luck.